What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. Today we're working next door to Charlie Meany's. By the way, the best tavern in town in the entire village of Valley Stream. Check them out. They're just in North Valley Stream, just south of the Sun State Parkway on North Central Avenue. And you know what the best part about Charlie Meany's is? Do you know what the best part about Charlie Meany's is?
Is that their employee of the month is no other than Akeem.
Guys, let me get a smash that thumbs up button, guys. Akeem is the employee of the month here. Awesome job, Akeem.
All right, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Here we are, the basement front. There's the Bilco door to bring down stuff. I'm parked right there, but here we have it. We have our... We have a 1-inch? Yeah, 1-inch water main coming in with galvanized fittings. Are these really galvanized fittings? Wow, is it really galvanized fittings? Yes, it is. That is a galvanized fitting. And so is that. So is that nipple right there. That's brass. That's brass. And that's brass. But everything else here, that's galvanized. Take a little knife and you can scrape it, the dirt off of it. So we have galvanized coming in, galvanized nipple right here. That, man, that may be lead. Hold on, I think this may be lead. Wow, this is gonna be some interesting stuff right here. That's lead. No, that's actually copper. We have 1-inch copper main coming into here. To our dresser coupling right there, to the locking water shutoff valve, another shutoff valve, a 5/8 meter. Look at that. See? 5/8 meter with the radio transmitter on top so they can read how much water you're using. The 1/2 inch IPS, 1/2 inch copper, 3/4 inch copper, and then our 3/4 inch water service here. Anyway, today we're here to install a Watts 3/4 inch double check valve. It's a code requirement here in New York State, just like many other states. But a double check valve installation here, right, basically provides an extra layer of protection, and it helps ensure that the public water supply remains safe and free from any contaminations that could occur in this building. Now, this building is being utilized now as a pharmacy here in the Village of Valley Stream. So there is a potential for cross-contamination. You know, if you have some drugs that are in a sink and you have a negative pressure or loss of pressure from the street side, without the means of a backflow prevention device here, any kind of, you know, pharmaceutical drugs that are sitting, you know, sucked into the hose faucet or sink for... Really, honestly, it makes no sense. Why they need a double check valve here, it really makes no sense. There's no hazard, but nonetheless, Liberty, the water company, has enforced the state regulations mandating that backflow prevention devices be installed when the hazard exists, or when they think a hazard exists. And good luck fighting a utility. They'll just turn off your water here, and good luck. All right, so one of the first things we need to do is determine directional flow, similar to when we're doing a backflow prevention prevention device test. Determine directional flow, and the directional flow is from right to left, evident by the water coming in from the foundation. So here is our backflow prevention device right here. We have an arrow on there, that's directional flow. Let's spin that around, and here we have it. And we're going to install this valve right here. Right, we're going to install that valve right here. We're going to cut that line and install this bad boy. So smash that thumbs up button in advance, because we're going to make a little bit of a mess here. All right, so I used some scratchy paper, open mesh grit cloth, and I cleaned the copper pipe where our Viga 3/4 inch press by mail unions are going to be located. Yep, one little device that does both. Look at that, one little fitting, sorry. One little fitting that does both. Looks sweet. Perfect. All right, perfect. So I'm going to use my Milwaukee M18. Nope, sorry, I wish they had an M18 fuel tubing cutter, but I got my M12 tubing cutter. I'm gonna cut the pipe, slam that bad boy in there. You ready? Let's do this. This is gonna go one of two ways. Either this is gonna work well or it's gonna be an epic failure, so. Far so good. Okay. Now have a little bit more of paint on this fitting. Sorry, on the pipe. Just using my open mesh scratching paper. And now we're going to make sure we install the Watts 007 M3QT DC, which is lead free. Make sure we put that in the proper orientation. That's slammed in there just like that perfectly. Get our other one in there as well. And now let's press it in. I want to orientate it just like that. Okay, let's get the first one in. And the second. And just like that, the job is complete. Almost. All right, now that my device is installed to make the occupants of the building, the employees of the building, of the store, the pharmacy, make them more comfortable, I got the water back on. I went upstairs. I told them, hey, listen, the water's going to be on for another couple more minutes. I have to do the test now that I have installed the valve. And I got the go-ahead to shut it down again. And we're going to use the Watts TK9A. A very, very expensive backflow device, differential valve that we use for testing the check valves, of this Watts 3/4 inch double check. So let's turn the water back off. But before we do so, let's review the steps in testing this valve. All right. These are the official New York State double check valve test procedures, using a 3-valve pressure differential test kit, like the Watts TK9A. First thing we're gonna do is determine direction of flow, which is from right to left and then bottom to top. Then we're gonna close shuttle valve number 2. After doing that, we're gonna blow off test cocks 2, 3, and 4, which are, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. We're gonna blow them off to remove any debris or dirt that may be accumulated there. Then we're gonna test check valve number 1. We're gonna connect our high pressure hose, right, to our test cock number 2, our low pressure to test cock number 3. And then we're gonna open up 2 and 3, and then we're gonna bleed the air from the high pressure hose through the high pressure control valve A and bypass valve control C. And then we're gonna close A, and we're gonna bleed air from the low pressure hose through the low side control valve B and bypass control valve C. We're gonna close valves B and C. Check valve number 1 must hold 1 PSI D to pass. If it doesn't, and then it fails, and the test stops there, and we make repairs. And if it passes, continue to check number 2. All right, so now that I just spewed all that gibberish out of my mouth, let's do this step by step. This is shut-off valve number 2. She's closed. We're going to blow off test cocks 2, 3, and 4 to allow us to test. I took the little caps off. One just fell. Of course, now it's not virgin anymore and clean. It's dirty. And we're going to blow off those test cocks with a flat screw. Good. High pressure hose to number 2. Okay. A low pressure hose to number 3. We're going to open test cocks 2 and number 3. We are now going to bleed air through A and bypass C. And then we're going to close A. Make sure your bypass hose goes into a receptacle for drainage. Now we're gonna bleed air through B and C. There's B, closing B, closing C. All right, now I'm supposed to have one PSID or greater, but unfortunately we don't. And I'm not saying the check valve number one here has failed. I'm saying that these test procedures are no bueno.
And that's why we're gonna use these test procedures, because these test procedures actually work. Why New York State decided to come out with this version, which is approved, I don't know, because it always gives me a failure. But this one doesn't. This one works. And it will not give you a false positive or a false negative. Yeah, you know what I mean.
So here is very simple. Do permanent direction of flow, close shutoff valve number two, blow test cocks 2, 3, and 4 to remove any debris, any foreign debris, right? We're going to connect high pressure hose to test cock number 3, and then we're going to open test cock 3. Then we're going to connect the high pressure hose, right? We're going to bleed the air out of the high pressure hose and follow these directions, which is close of control valve B, leave control valve A open.
All right, so I have my high pressure hose connected to test port number 3.
Okay, we're going to bleed air through A and B. Okay, we're closing B. The needle should stay pegged on the high side,
which it is.
Next, we're going to close control valve number 1. The needle's still staying there. If it did not stay there, the check valve is faulty and needs to be repaired or replaced.
Next, we're going to slowly open control valve B to our needle drops to 2 PSID. Right there, perfect. And now we're gonna open test port number 2, okay? And the needle should stay there. There it is, and it stayed. Check valve number 1 has passed.
Next, we're gonna close test port number 3. We're gonna remove high pressure hose from test port 3, attach it to test port number 4, okay? Now, I am going to open test port number 4. I'm going to restore water service through shutoff valve number 1. Make sure I close that. Open that. Okay. Good. Let's bleed air from A through B. Good. Needle set pegged on the high side. Let's close shutoff valve number 1. Let's drop this to 2 PSID. Too much. Let's open that back up. Okay. High side. Perfect. Let's close shutoff valve number 1. Let's drop this to 2 PSID again. Let's not overshoot it this time. Right there. Perfect. Now we're going to open test port number 3. And she stayed. So shutoff, double check valve number 1 and 2 have both passed. And that's how you do it, ladies and gentlemen.
All right, last but not least, I installed a valve tag, marking what the valve does, which is a main water valve. There's our company, there's our phone number, there's our website. Perfect. If you guys don't use valve tags, I highly suggest you do it. If you guys need valve tags or even need a website for your contracting business, there's a link down in the description box down below for a special offer. Footbridge Media, I used them when I first started back in 2008 and 2009. They got me set up with a website, the whole monthly internet search engine, internet marketing, and the whole SEO, the optimization, any print service and mail they take care of. But they have a really great price on these valve tags. But if you need a website for your contracting business, I think it's $250 a month. There's no contract, no commitment, no nothing. But they'll give you an amazing website. They'll get you presence on the internet, and they can take care of all your social media. They have a lot of different packages available. Check them out, footbridgemedia.com. Link in the description box down below. Tell them Mikey Pipes sent you. They'll take care of you, and they'll take care of me a little bit as well. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Until next time, be well. God bless. Stay safe. Smash that thumbs up button, guys. Thanks for watching.